Just one more question. One source of disconnect, and perhaps in the church for young people, is that a lot of them have gay friends. They have more open attitudes towards LGBT issues. I know the church still forbids same-sex marriage or doesn't recognize it, but you have referenced before the compromise in Utah that took place where Mormons supported a statewide protection of LGBT rights against discrimination while also protecting religious freedoms. So talk about that, how such compromises might fit within your beliefs or might work.
Sure, I think, you know, it's important to realize from my perspective, we live in a pluralistic society and there are many people who have many beliefs. And there's a wide range of beliefs. And so I think it's important that the church recognize that. So when it comes to, for example, housing rights and employment rights, these are basic fundamental human rights, and the church supports those. And nobody, LGBT, straight, married, single, old, young, nobody should be discriminated against because of their sexual orientation and those other things I mentioned. In those areas. Those are basic human rights, to have shelter and housing and employment and decent respect. We all have our institutions, churches have policies, our revelation, our moral codes, our ethical codes, and to us they're sacred and important, but that doesn't mean that we judge anybody else. You know, if someone in good conscience is doing the best they can, we do the best we can, and we respect each other and work together and find areas of common concern where we can work together. So I think it's important to realize that, you know, our Lord Jesus Christ ate with sinners. Now, I'm not saying they're sinners. I'm going to be careful. I'm not drawing an analogy here. I'm simply saying that Jesus was open to everybody. And he didn't judge that. He didn't say, oh, well, you're a sinner, I'm not here with you. So the point is, we have to be open to everybody. We, you know, I think, again, you know, we have to be careful. There's a tendency to be judgmental. You can't judge another person. Only a person, himself or herself, can say whether they formed their conscience properly and doing the best they can with what the gifts that God has given them. And so we have to just take people where they are, respect them, be loving toward them, compassionate toward them. There may be certain things we disagree with, but we do our best to move forward.